You are listening to OS from the BBC World Service. We have another visitor to our desk today. Kerry Allen is here, our China media analyst from BBC Monitor. Hi, Kerry. Good to have you with us. Now, I want to start with these yellow bikes that we sometimes see around London as well. It's a bike sharing company in China called Ofo. Why are they in the news?
They're in the news because millions of people have been requesting refunds from the company, because recently there have been reports that the company is heading into administration. It's been suffering a lot with the competitiveness of a lot of these kind of rent-a-bike schemes, companies emerging in China, I mean all over the world. You see them here in London. And it's really struggled to kind of maintain its business model. There have also been reports that a lot of these bikes get dumped, and these amazing pictures where you see just piles of bikes that have just been like just abandoned and they're all broken, etc. There have been queues. There have been hundreds of people queuing outside the office trying to get refunds. There have been 10 million is the figure that the reports are saying online of the number of people who are actually trying to get refunds. And the company's response is basically that it's you got to get in line. so some people might be waiting ages before they actually get a refund, and they're saying it could take months.
And then some were upset, if I read it correctly, that they felt Chinese customers were being treated differently to other customers.
Yes, and this is absolutely realistic because, for example, people who speak English, there'll normally be different customer service hotlines for these. I mean, I've seen it in train stations in China that you'll have, if people want to get a refund, there'll be a line for people who speak English, which is really, really short, and then a really long line for Chinese customers. It's not clear what the criteria is at the moment. There are people physically queuing outside. The company's saying that people are being gradually refunded. But there's a lot of sympathy for this company online, because it was one of the trailblazers, really, of rentable bike schemes in China. People thought it was fantastic about 5 years ago.
And why didn't it work?
Because there have been so many other companies emerging.
Right.
This company hasn't really kind of maintained its business model, its USP, that there are struggles to basically recognize it as the one individual brand anymore. And it didn't catch up with things like security, so people could very easily manipulate these bikes without having to kind of scan a QR code and take it away. People were nicking them, they were throwing them into rivers, the company didn't really catch up with being able to kind of maintain its grasp on it being the kind of company associated with rentable bikes.
I see one of the rentable bikes near my house, and somebody has locked it. They've come out and used like a lock to lock it to a lamppost or whatever, so that they always have access to it.
Oh,
but they're not
gosh.
Returning it. I don't understand it totally. But anyway, I'll think of Ofo, because sometimes you do see them in about the oddest places in London. Let me turn to hacking instead, because you've also been looking at those US accusations of hacking aimed at a Chinese group linked to the intelligence agencies.
Yes, there's been a report today that the US Justice Department has indicted two Chinese men. They've been accused of hacking into computer networks of Western countries, and the Foreign Ministry in China has seen these reports, and they issued a statement today saying that these accusations are groundless, and using very, very strong language, accusing the US and saying that they think it's antagonizing. There's a lot of frictions between China and the US for a number of reasons at the moment, the ongoing trade war. And so they're just seeing this as the latest kind of action to kind of bully Chinese people and to try and hold them. Now, they've not actually been arrested, these two people. They're being charged. They both work at a company called Huaying Huaitai. A little information's been given on them. But in China, people are very, very angry. Lots of angry comments online targeted at the US.
Kerry Allen, thank you very much for coming over, filling us in on a couple of the stories that she's following for us in China.